Hello guys, welcome to another tutorial. In this tutorial today we are going to discuss about the transformation toolbar. What the transformation toolbar do, which is actually present in the insert, or you can go to the insert to insert menu and go to transformation, and you can see your mirror, rectangular pattern, circular pattern and user pattern and so on. Okay, let's start. I'm going to do first this mirror feature. What this mirror feature do, it actually mirrors your body. I'm going to select XY plane and choose a sketch. Now I'm going to draw a profile which I want to do mirror. Okay, I'm drawing a circle here. This is a circle, or you can assign some dimension if you want. If you are not assigning this dimension, then it is okay. Now selecting, I'm giving the dimension from the center of the circle to the vertical. Just double click and assign some dimension. Okay, after exiting, I am selecting this first of all you have to activate the sheet metal parameter, because unless you do not activate the sheet metal parameter, other commands will not activate. So just activate it, and you by default a sheet metal parameters dialog box comes in, and the thickness is 2 mm by default and default band radius is 4. If you want to change the thickness, you can change, and then okay. Now select this wall feature, or you can go to insert, walls and wall feature. Click and OK. Now I am going to mirror this this geometry or sheet by this XY plane. Now select this sheet mirror. After selecting this mirror, now I have to assign mirroring plane which I want to mirror. By which I want to mirror. Now I am going to select this XY plane, and the element to mirror is my current body. So if you're done with it, then you can click OK. Now this is your mirror command. And next I have, which is rectangular pattern. Actually what rectangular pattern do, it patterns your body or the object you want to pattern in rectangular way. Now which is you are going to see in my tutorial. Now I'm just cut, no, and then select mechanical design and go to generative sheet metal design. Now select XY plane and choose a sketch, draw a centered rectangle. I am drawing a centered rectangle. Just double click on the dimension dialog box and double click. I am assigning the dimension 100 to it. Okay, and I am assigning 100 dimension to it also. Okay, now exit. After exiting the again you have to activate this sheet metal parameter, because I have told you earlier. Just click on the sheet and okay. Now you need to draw some profile into it. So select this surface and choose a sketch. Now I am drawing some profile here. For example, this is my profile, a simple profile. Exit. Now select this extrude feature, extrusion definition, and select inward direction and click and drag to the bottom side. Okay, now select a rectangular pattern, or you can go to insert, choose transformation and select rectangular pattern. You have to click on the object which you want to do pattern. I want to do this pattern. Click. Now as soon as you click on the this object, a dialog box comes into play, which is rectangular pattern definition. Now it is asking for you first direction and second direction. First direction is I have to give the direction from here, reference direction. By selecting this reference direction, I am going to select this edge for the direction, for first direction. And you have instance. What is instance? This body is your basically instance, and the spacing between two stance you can select or you can change. I am clicking this upper direction arrow for increasing my instance, and you can increase or decrease your distance between your instance. You have many more option, spacing length, so you have spacing and length. So for your convenience you can select any one of these. I'm selecting this instance and spacing, which is okay. And now I have a second direction. I am selecting this edge for second direction. Click on reference direction and select this direction and click this upward button. See, the pattern is generating in opposite direction. You can reverse the direction by clicking on this reverse direction button, and you can adjust the spacing between these by clicking on this. Now the, as you can see in the preview, the pattern is completed almost, and if you okay with it, then choose okay. Okay, this is your rectangular pattern. Now I have a second pattern, which is our user pattern. After that I will tell you circular pattern. First user pattern, I am just select rectangular pattern, right click and delete. Okay, for actually what your user pattern will do, you have to give some point on this sheet. Actually this point is your position where you want to pattern your instance, or where you are going to pattern your instance. I am clicking on this sketch, surface, and select sketch. Now give some point, just double click for multiple operation, where you want your stance. Double click. This side. Okay. Exit. This instance will take place of this point, these points. So I am going to select this user stamp, select, click on this instance, and you have object extrusion 1, which is this, and position, these points are my position. As soon as you click on the points, your pattern will generate automatically. If you are okay with it, then choose okay. This is your user pattern. This is why it is called user pattern, because you are giving your points by your own wish. Now next I have, which is circular pattern. Just start mechanical design and generative sheet metal design. Click on XY plane and choose a sketch. Draw a circle here, any size you want. I'm assigning 100 dimension to it. And after exiting, you again have to activate the sheet metal parameter first, and then okay, select this wall feature and choose this circle to make a sheet. Okay, now select the surface and choose a sketch. I'm going to draw a circle here. Now again assign some dimension for convenience, double click, and I'm giving 4 diameter, and click send from center point to this point. I am assigning some dimension, which is 14. It's okay, and exit. After exiting, I am selecting this cutout feature, which is present in insert cutting feature, and select this cutout feature. This arrow should be inward direction, because if it is in outward direction, your this portion will remain in the screen, and the rest portion will delete, or will, you can say, deactivate. Okay, now my cutout is generated, and I'm going to select this circular feature. After circular feature, you have to click on this circular feature, cutout feature, and your circular pattern definition box will appear on the screen. Now same again, instance and angular spacing. Now you have to give the direction. Just right click on this, the axis, choose the axis around which this circular cutout pattern will going to happen. I am selecting this Z axis, because according to this, the Z axis is useful for me, and just right click and select this Z axis. After selecting the Z axis, a preview is shown here. Now instances do, because the instances might 2, 3, 4, 5, or you can adjust the angular spacing by just clicking on this. I am decreasing some value. Okay, it's okay for me. Now if you do okay, the pattern will remain like this. But if you want to choose crown definition, which is very good feature, personally I like it most, circle is 1, and click on this feature, as you can see, the pattern will showing outward direction also. Now I am decreasing the distance between them. Okay, 2, 3, 4. Okay, it's okay. And if you're done with it, then okay, your circular pattern will showing on the screen. Another feature is I have some translation, rotation and symmetry. Actually what translation do, it moves your object from one point to another point. Just go to insert, select transformation and choose this translation feature. After selecting this translation feature, some message will show on the screen, then click on the yes button. And now you have to select the direction which you want to move your body, move your sheet. Just right click and I am selecting this Y direction and click, and you can click on drag easily this arrow, or you can by inserting some value here. Okay, this is our translation command. And now I have rotation command. Just click on the rotation command. Again a message is showing on the screen, just yes, do yes, and you have to click on select the axis. Just right click the axis you want to rotate this object. I am selecting the Z direction. After selecting this Z direction, you can easily rotate by clicking and dragging this arrow around the axis. Okay, this is our rotate command. Next I have a symmetry. Just select this symmetry and you need to select the plane about which you want to create a symmetry, and I am selecting this ZX plane. So your symmetry will create. See, the after selecting this symmetry feature, the object will delete from here and showing on the continue to showing on the another side, and then okay, this is our symmetry feature. Next is axis to axis. See, I am going to make a separate video for this. And so this is all about transformation toolbar. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, please subscribe our channel, and thank you.